You know the Obama administration imposed some sanctions on some top Syrian officials today, stopped short of severing diplomatic relations, recalling the ambassador, or even calling on President Bashar al-Assad to step down. Does the U.S. need to go further right now?
Well, Wolf, it's the least we can do. We can actually sanction some members of the regime. But let's face it, what's the regime? The regime is Bashar al-Assad himself. The regime is his younger brother Maher, the killer of the regime. The regime is his sister Bushra. The regime is his brother-in-law Asif Shawkat. So you can sanction them. You can sanction the barons, the intelligence barons. You can hold the property that they have in Bethesda or Chevy Chase, but it is of no consequence in the long run. What this is about, it's about a regime fighting for its privileges and for its power. And it's about Washington waking up to the fact that the belief in the ultimate redemption and the ultimate moderation of Bashar al-Assad was always an illusion.
Here's the part of the White House statement released today. I'll read it to you, Fouad. Yeah. The United States believes that Syria's deplorable actions toward its people warrant a strong international response. Yes. We call on President Assad to change course now and heed the calls of his own people. A statement like that, plus the sanctions imposed today, is that going to scare Bashar al-Assad?
It won't scare Bashar al-Assad, and I think in Washington we all have to think our ways. For example, there is one of our great luminaries in foreign policy, Senator John Kerry, chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. Many, many others have bet that they can go to Damascus and sweet-talk Bashar out of his terror and out of his radicalism. We have to see the regime for what it is. Now, once we see it, can we do much about it? I really am afraid not. The Syrian people, in large measure, are on their own. We are trying to help the Libyans, but I am afraid, as far as Syria is concerned, it's the regime against the people. The people don't want this regime, but they don't know how to overthrow it. The regime has formidable instruments of terror. They have these vigilante squads like the Basij in Iran, and they go everywhere and do whatever they want.